Okay, here's another super fun animation tutorial for After Effects. This is just really a simple bouncing rubber ball. And it's pretty basic, but it should give you an opportunity to learn some of the features, some of the effects if you're new to After Effects. This is a fun one to follow. Just make a bouncing ball and then, you know, then you'll have that skill, making a bouncing ball. So yeah, who doesn't want that? Okay, so what I'm gonna do is recreate this entire thing we're looking at right here. And it's pretty simple. We're going to start with a new composition, whatever size suits your fancy. Start there, and let's put some background. Just background, you can use anything, but let's put a solid in here. And I think I'm going to start with just a sort of a light gray, almost white. And then we'll put another solid, a new solid, and this one will be maybe bluish, right? I don't know. That sounds good. And this is a simple trick I use quite a bit. Zoom out, grab this mask layer here. So sometimes it's a shape layer, sometimes it's a mask layer. Just depends on if you have a layer selected or not. I have this bluish layer selected, so I'm gonna draw a mask on here and open up the mask properties. I'm gonna feather it, all right, and I'll click away and just see what that looks like. Oh, that's okay. We can adjust it. Maybe I want this a little bit grayer. Layer solid settings. If I want to adjust the solid there, you can also just put a fill layer on top of it, but this lets me see it. Yeah, I think I'll keep it maybe how it was. We'll adjust later if need be. Okay, let's get to the ball. That's the real fun stuff. All right. So again, I'm still selected here. My shape tool. I'm going to have the ellipse selected. Now with no layers selected, I will just draw a circle, right? If I hold down shift, it keeps it pretty smooth, pretty circular. In fact, it's completely circular. I can change the settings. I can make it a red ball. I like red because it sort of is a ball color. Now I'm not going to have any stroke on this. I'm just going to keep it to the fill only in a stroke of zero. This is actually maybe a little too big for my taste. So if I, again, if I just grab it and scale it down, same thing, hold down shift and it constrains things for me. All right, so if I click on the shape, I see that the anchor point or the center point is right here. To move that, I hit this tool or select Y. And I can move this is the rotation point or the center point or the anchor point. And if I hold down shift, it keeps it, well, or control, hold down control, keeps it locked in place. I can lock it to a corner, any one of these spots, or I put it in the center. So if you want it perfectly centered, that's great. Then you can really, if you want to center it to your comp, you use this align window. This is found up in window align, if you're not seeing that, and I'll align horizontally, and I'll also align vertically. So now it's perfectly in the center. However, I'm gonna take it and move it again. I'm gonna move it down here, hold down control, and now it's aligned right to that bottom. And the reason I do that is because I'm gonna make this bounce and squish a little bit, and I want it to squish. I guess that'll make sense in a second. So I'm gonna zoom back out and select my selection tool. You can hit V, always go back to that. And here's my circle. In fact, it's still a little too big for me. So hit S, we're gonna scale it down. Maybe we'll enter a value of 75. That's how big I want my circle, all right? Now we're gonna keyframe the position. So this comp is like 60 seconds long. I'm gonna put it down to maybe about 3 or 4 or 5 seconds. Trim comp to work area. Now we have a shorter comp. We're gonna keyframe the position. Hit P, that'll open up the position for this layer here. While we're at it, I'm gonna rename and call this ball so I don't forget later. It's a good thing to name your layers, especially when you get several of them. It gets very confusing. Okay, so we have the Japanese flag here that we're looking at, and we're going to keyframe the position. We hit that little stopwatch icon, and that drops a position. It drops a keyframe right here in the timeline. Right now, as long as I'm right over this, my timeline cursor is right over the keyframe here, I can move this, and I'm gonna put it out of the viewing area. And then I'm going to slide in here a little bit, move it forward in time. And I'm going to put this here, and then I'll create another keyframe. And then we'll have it up here. And now if I go back and I start there and hit the space bar to play it, I have this basic, simple bounce. I'm also going to take my work area and move it down to about 2 seconds and right click trim comp to work area. Now if I hit this, it'll sort of loop over and over so I can watch it and make creative decisions. The first one that I see is that I want to actually move this. So if I have this layer selected, this is my path right here. It's got this keyframe path, and I can move this as long as my cursor is right over there. I can move this. I can even move the start and end points. I can have this bounce here, and I can have this start up here. Now, let's see how this looks. Boom. Boom. Let's have this. I want this to go a little faster after it bounces, so I'm going to move the keyframe forward. Boom. There we go. Very basic, very simple. Let's add in that squish effect to make this ball look a little bit more bouncy. Now, again, I have my anchor point right there. Hit S to open up scale, and I'm going to keyframe that. And now I can close this and reopen, and I'll see these here. Or if I hit U, that just automatically opens up only the things that have keyframes on them. So I'm going to adjust the scale properties here. So when it bounces, I want it to squish down from 75. But look what happens is if I adjust this, it just gets smaller. I just want the height, which is this second one. And if I unlink them right here, now I'm just adjusting the height. So I'm going to squish it down so that when it bounces, it squishes, and then it's going to grow back up to 75. In fact, maybe instead of growing back up, it gets even larger, and then goes back down to 75. Let's zoom out. Let's see how that looks. All right. Little bouncy. What I'm actually going to do, even though the ball shouldn't technically squish until it hits the ground, I'm going to move the bounce squish back a little bit so it starts to squish there and bounces back up. So a couple things to make this more real. You can tweak this as much as you like, but right here is just your basic bounce. It's got a little squish to it. But if I want this to look a little bit more realistic, I can adjust the position. Here's one thing I can do is go up here to my pen tool, and I'm going to select Convert Vertex. See, I can draw this path here. I could edit it, add points. But what I'm going to do is convert this center vertex right here. And it helps if I center my timeline. So now if I click and hold that down, it lets me kind of adjust that a little bit. If I hold down Alt, I'm just adjusting one side, right? But if I let go, it adjusts them evenly. So I'm going to stretch this out so it's sort of a bounce that looks like that. Hit play. Oh, a little smoother. So you can play with that. You can play with your ball as much as you like until you get it right. Yep. To make it even more realistic, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to add in a rotation. Because right now the ball squishes and then it stretches back up and it stretches even more. I'm going to really exaggerate this. So hit U to open up my properties, and the scale, instead of scaling up that much, it's going to go like way higher. Okay. So it's going to bounce up like that and then back to a normal level. And this is fun. To make it realistic, hit R, keyframe the rotation, hit U so that they're all open. And so now I'm going to actually have this rotate in this direction, and it's created that squish, but let's move this up and then move these two rotation positions up a little bit so it sort of bounces in that direction. Now, somewhat believable. I actually have to have it swing back, I think. So let's rotate it back to zero. Now, let's see if this looks real. That's not bad. It's a little bit of a bounce. You can really mess with it. You can really exaggerate the squash too if you want. You can have it go down that flat. Ooh. That's a very exaggerated bounce. I'm going to leave it like that just for fun. And one thing we can do is we can turn on motion blurring. Turn it on there for all layers, and then turn it on for the individual layer. And now we we've got a little motion blur. It's a little blur when the object moves. All right. So now I think I'm going to add in, make this ball. It just looks like a flat ball right now. I'm going to add in, let's turn off motion blurring so we can see it. What I need to do is add a gradient, but I want it to be added directly on this shape. I want a fill. I want a gradient fill instead of just this solid fill. Now you can go up here and there's several options. I like to add it right here. Make sure I have my ellipse, my particular shape selected. You could have multiple shapes inside of a shape layer. Add fill, gradient fill, and that'll put the gradient fill right there. You see this? We have this gradient that we can adjust. And then what I'm going to do is adjust the colors. So let's twirl down gradient fill, edit gradient. Now we can change the colors. Let's make it red. And these are my two colors. You can add colors in here and do whatever you like. But I'm going to make this dark, sort of a dark red, a little brighter. Okay, great. And instead of a linear fill, I want a radial fill. Now we can adjust this. And I'm going to put this side here, almost like the light is coming from the top there. And if I select away from that layer, I can see this sort of looks a little bit more like a ball. Let's adjust the gradient a little bit more. Maybe we'll make this a little darker. Yeah, I like that. Okay. And we'll make the bright a little brighter. Let's go back to that. Yeah. Beautiful. Zoom out and let's hit play. Looks okay. Let's turn motion blurring back on. Motion blur, and now we have a very bouncy, semi-realistic looking ball. Last thing I'm gonna do here is make a little reflection for the ball. And an easy way to do that is just hit Control-D, duplicate the layer, and right click, I'm gonna pre-compose this, and I'm gonna call this I'm gonna call it reflection. Great. And now we have two layers. This one I'm going to flip upside down. You can do transform flip vertical. So now, look at this. Now we have two balls. That's really wild. Okay, I don't want that. What I do want is at the point where the ball, select my ball layer, hit U to open up my layer keyframe properties, and the position right here when it gets right into the center and bounces, this is where I want them to meet. So I'll select my reflection layer, put it underneath the ball layer, and I'm going to move this so that it's right there. Now, when it plays, it's sort of a reflection. To make it more reflection looking, I'm going to add the Gaussian blur. There it is, already selected. I had that pulled up from earlier. I'll turn this up way up to like 100, and then I'm going to hit T, turn down the opacity, bring it back to the beginning, and watch the magic unfold. Now it looks like sort of it's bouncing off this reflective surface. Now you could certainly, if you wanted to make this reflection more of a shadow, you could do that, or add anything, different backgrounds, several balls. You can just have fun with it. So that's a simple way to make a bouncing ball with reflection. It's a little bit more than just a simple flat ball. All right. Have fun with your balls.